Hello everyone, thank you very much for watching today. Today is Friday, October 2nd, and today I want to go over and the theme for today. Are you being lazy or doing the things that you need to do to get to your business to where you are? So if you watched the video yesterday, did you recap of where you are year to date? Have you been lazy, or are you doing the things that you need to do to get your business where you are? So I'm going to give you a list of a few things to always keep in mind. You've heard me say some of these before, but just like I said yesterday, today, October, it's a very important month to make sure the end of the year ends up well for you, better than what you expected, better than what you want, better than what you can even imagine, and you can get these things done. And start prepping, preparing for next year. You should never always just be in prepare mode. You know, you should be throughout the year, be consistent with everything you're doing. You shouldn't, you know, I see this every year at the end of the year or in January, end of January, everybody getting ready. You should be always ready. Ready for the market, ready for this, because if you've heard me say this, I have a lot of brand new agents this year, a lot of brand new agents right out of school. Some of you are watching this video. Today is the best time to get into real estate. So a little disclaimer that I've is that this is my opinion and what I've seen from 28 years and why I believe this is the best time for you to be in real estate. So I'm taking you back. A little quick story that 28 years ago, when I got in the real estate business, your office, where it was located and where you were, was very, 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 very important. Your office controlled the leads. Your office controlled the market. Your office was the most important thing that you had to pick because to even get business. This is before the internet, before cell phones were even that popular. So the consumers used to call, say they want to buy a house on the east side of Cleveland, west side of Cleveland, Columbus, wherever they wanted to buy a house, they used to have to go drive to that office or call that office and talk to an agent. And we used to have floor time and they would sit there and we'd all want the perfect time of floor time to answer the phone because people used to call the office. I want to buy a house in where I was in the Lyndhurst office of a company. That's where I wanted to work. So people wanted to buy a house in Lyndhurst. Either they drove to the real estate office in Lyndhurst or they called the office in Lyndhurst, looked up at that old big book called the phone book. So the point I'm getting at is back then you had to position yourself in an office that where you wanted to do business because unless you were marketing yourself, which agents still did, but people still called offices more often than agents. I saw it. I was in the market. I saw it then. So all of the agents and over half of the realtors in the United States today have not been licensed more than 10 years. So they don't know anything before 10 years ago. And a lot of you maybe watching this weren't born 28 years ago. I can't believe that's happening. I'm saying that. But so now I tell all of you, and then many of you have heard this because when you joined our office, is that this is the best time I feel for agents to get businesses. It's time for you. You're total in control of your business. There's agents and companies on the east side of Cleveland, sell on the west side of Cleveland. People and consumers are not brand specific in office specific in a certain area. What I mean by that is great to be, and of course my opinion, to be with a great brand company that has all the tools, technology, training, support, everything that an agent needs. That's different. But on a consumer side of things, they're not looking for the broker and the office as much as the agent first. They look at the agent, I think, more often, and then they look, make sure the agent's with a company that they know and trust, know that the agent has the backing of a great company that they know and trust also. Kind of a 1-2 punch, so to say. So this is why I'm saying this is the best time to be in real estate. If you're not taking advantage of the market now, when are you going to take advantage of the market? This is a great market, historically low interest rates. Yes, there is inventory problems. not problems. There's less inventory, just a little bit harder, a little harder work. We'll find the inventory. That's it. It's simple and as hard as that. So here's a couple things to think about. Number one, you have to have big goals. You just have to have, you can't have these little tiny goals. Like I'm going to have one sale extra this year, one more sale. If you want to succeed at a certain level, those goals have to succeed where you want to be. See, they excel. They got to get further than where you want to be. Two, you have to surround yourself with like-minded people. It doesn't have to be realtors, just people that understand sales. I put this stage, you have to be around other people that understand sales, understand customer service. It doesn't have to be in your same industry. People that have to work hard and have the ability. If you're hanging around all people that just have 9-to-5 jobs, have no opportunity to work a little bit harder, you'll know this. I'm not saying this to put anybody down, anybody who works 9-to-5, but I've been around a lot of 9-to-5 type people, and I go, why don't you get to work an hour early? Well, they don't pay me. Why would I get to work an hour early? Why don't you pick up the phone if they need help after hours? Ah, they don't pay me for that. If you get around those type of people, they're not going to understand why you're taking a call at 9 o'clock at night. They're not going to understand why you are showing houses till 11 o'clock at night, why you're working on an offer at midnight, why you're working on a Sunday, why you were an hour late to dinner when you had dinner plans because you got stuck at some showings that took a lot longer because the people wanted to write an offer on the last house they saw. If you're not around like-minded people, they pull you down. So either you have to have really good people that understand, that are not in the same mindset and not in the same like-minded category, or start hanging around people that understand that or have been there before, at least. They had that type of job. And definitely don't hang around or talk to realtors that fail. I've heard this so many times. Oh, my mother or my aunt was in the business. She got out of it a couple years ago. And then they just commiserate that you're talking to people that are no longer in the business. Maybe if they retired and they were very happy with it, but if they were no longer in the business and they get out, they're just going to tell you how they make excuses of why they failed and blame the market and tell you, bring you down. Don't do that. I see that. So three, always be training, always be learning, always be watching videos, always, if you, again, our Century 21 Homestar agents, always be on 21 online in our online university, Century 21 University. We have classes. There's live classes daily. There's classes there. Learn as you go. There's programs that start every couple months that are a few weeks or a few months long, different types of programs of getting buyers and sellers or different ideas. But any agent out there, there are other avenues. Reach out to your brand. Reach out to your office. You're going to have things you can learn. With YouTube, there's lots of coaches. There's Tom Ferry. There's Brian Buffini. There's Mike Ferry. There's Jared James. There's different coaches that are on there that you might like more personally. And so there's always something that you could be learning, but you can't learn and never do. So limit that time. You got to be a little, number four, be flexible, understand change. If things aren't working for you, if you might get burnt out of certain things, like, you know, if you're prospecting every day a certain way, I'm sending, you know, 100 text messages and calls and voicemails and individual emails and handwritten notes, you might have to switch it up a little bit just so you're fresh, so you're not getting burnt out in what you do. Number five, you got to go the extra mile. There's so many agents out there, and I see not today to, and I think this year is one of the busiest I've seen for new agents, people getting their license. So we're going to be uptick of more agents in the real estate business, just for a lot of reasons. I've talked to, and many of you might be watching this who are new to Century 21 Homestar, I got your license this year. We have many, many of you and many more on the way, is that career change. Want a second job, they got their hours cut, they see other friends. I see this all the time. I have agents right now, like my friend's a realtor, they were doing great, so I figured I'd get my license, start part-time, work hard, and then build to be full-time someday. I hear this story almost daily, several times a week. So you have to work hard because there's more people coming in, but there's always a piece of the pie. There's always a piece of the pot. You can't blame not being successful at anything other than yourself. I'm serious about this. You can't blame anybody other than yourself for not getting to where you are, because everybody, there's people out there. You could find them. You could talk to them. You could connect with them. You could have quality conversations with them. Everybody has that opportunity. Doesn't matter if you just moved to the area yesterday. Doesn't matter. Sometimes I hear that from age. Well, I just moved back, or I just moved from out of state, so I don't know anybody. Doesn't matter. There's still a piece of the real estate pie that, that you can get and earn. Number six, avoid lazy people. It's kind of like being in the right mindset. If you're around lazy people all the time, I know it's hard. I'm just not saying, before I say this, I'm not saying that your spouse or significant other is lazy. I'm just saying if they're not, and I use that as an example, because if you're around someone all the time, if you're friends or your family or your wherever, if you're around people that are just not active, it's going to be hard. They're going to bring you down. They're going to bring you down because they want to be lazy and you can't be lazy. And usually the times after hours, after five weekends, when some people like to be more lazy, is when you have to thrive and you have to work harder. So watch for that. And then last, you just have to be in an unstoppable mindset. You have to be of a great mindset. Sincerely, I'm not, you know, blowing smoke here. This is the best sales to be in. Every single person could be a possible client someday. And I stress this so many times, doesn't matter where you are. If you have friends, relatives, acquaintances, network outside your area that you'll service, you could earn a referral fee. You're licensed realtor. That means if anybody buys a house anywhere else in the country with a realtor and you work out a referral fee, you can get paid for that. You can't do that if you don't have a license. So it gives you that ability. So if your broker, your manager, your team leader, your mentor hasn't told you to start looking outside your area, not just look for people that you are going to put around in your car and yourself, or you know, drive and service 100% yourself. Look outside that area. Just call, have them call you first, connect with an agent in that area, work out a referral fee for referring them back to you, and you'll be happy for that. And I have some agents occasionally each year get more money in referral fees than they got selling their own properties that they did completely 100% themselves. And then they sit back and go, wow, I got these checks for X amount of dollars, and that was just a couple hours of my time. It wasn't, you know, days and weeks and months of looking at houses and multiple offers and all of that. So wow, how could great referrals be? You let another agent do all that and take a little piece of their commission. Think outside the box. Have an unstoppable mindset. This is definitely the best time, in my opinion. Anybody in real estate that wants to succeed in real estate can. There's no one stopping them. There's no reason to not get the business. Where 95% or more of people are using realtors to sell their house. So you can't say it's technology, there's another way, or you can't blame it on Zillow or realtor.com or the internet. You can't. Over the last few years, last few decades, there's always some type of excuse agents would use. I remember the internet's coming. Oh my God, that's why we're not getting business. Oh my God, Zillow's coming in. We're losing business. Oh, you know, people are going to be able to buy and sell themselves. We're going to lose business. No, none of that has happened. The agents are thriving more now than they ever have, and hope, and I don't have a crystal ball, hope that continues for decades, decades, decades to come. But now is the time to make the decision and do that. You can take advantage of it. You can get a piece of the market. You can do it. Everybody has that ability. Don't be lazy. Don't blame anything or anybody other than yourself if you're not where you want to be. And then last, of course, use me as a resource. Let me know if you need any help. if you want to start, if you haven't, many of you already are, but if you haven't gotten on a monthly coaching call with me, I'm happy one-on-one. Every week we'll get on a coaching call. I'm sorry if I said month, but every week, coaching call, minimum 20 minutes. We'll go over things, how you're doing, what you're doing, be accountable, and see what we can do to generate more business over the week. That's what I love to do. So if you're not on a coaching call with me, text me. We'll schedule it and start doing it now before the end of the year so you're off to a good start and finish the year strong. So that's it for today. Have a great Friday. Have a wonderful weekend, and we'll see you on Monday at 11. Bye-bye.